I want to jump straight in and do this video. Over the last 3 weeks, I joined in the last attempt, I guess, in the latter stages of attempt to find a Christian partner, you know, a female that's also Christian. And to be honest, Christian Connect is just like any other. It's just like a secular dating website. There are people on it that are just really not really Christians. There are some that are Christians, but their majority of them are not Christians. And it should really be a way that it's focused on faith and on genuine love of God and Christ in the whole process. So just to give you a rundown, I managed out of all success to see a woman twice on the Christian woman that was through the website, twice on the Christian Connect. And unlike, and just similar to years before, where I also went out on a, you know, on a date, I found that, you know, that with this woman, you know, I held hands with her and prayed, and it seemed to be like, I thought, a chemistry. But I received, like the secular one of RSP VP that I tried years ago, I was told that by the woman that she felt no chemistry with me, and that she wanted to cancel the outing that I planned, which was tomorrow to go to Mount Tambourine to the rose nursery up there, because I thought she would like to get a yellow rose and I would accompany with her, which I thought was the you know, God's way of actually doing something, going to see beauty and seeing the incense of perfume and things like that. Look, I'm really committed to finding out what can be done to assist through the Lord, through Christ, on what can be done to better equip and support those of us that are on the autism spectrum especially. I think the biggest danger in the dating process, the difficulty is that women don't, you know, they're looking at men that they're seeing as neurotypical, but men on the autism spectrum, we suffer mind blindness. We don't have any way of actually expressing. We never really get beyond the first or second date anyway to be able to add more to the connection. There's never a chance for us to ever really be known. There's always this high expectation that there must be chemistry in the very early stages, and if it's no chemistry, then it's a write-off. And I think that there's very high expectations on these websites, and I think that they're very destructive and very, very, very hurtful for low self-esteem, people with low self-esteem and difficulties and things like that. And what I found also was when I was speaking to this woman that she was interested only in my financial. She was from El Salvador, but she was living here in Australia, in Brisbane, Ipswich, and she was wanting to find out me about my financial situation. That doesn't sit with me. The thing is that when we are God's disciples, we love each other in God. We love people not of the world, because the money and the materialism and the lust all comes of the world, but to actually love in God's love of agape love. I just sort of wanted to read what came to mind after this experience in Genesis 3, because it was the woman that led the man also to, and I'm not saying that I dislike women, but when we just, I'm just going to read this verse to you, and you've heard it before, and I know some people won't want to listen, but the fall of man in Genesis 3, the entry of Satan into the world causing man to sin is in this verse, the fall of man. Now the serpent was more cunning than any beast of the field which the Lord God had made, and he said to the woman, "Has God indeed said, you shall not eat of every tree of the garden?" And the woman said to the serpent, "We may eat the fruit of the trees of the garden, but of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God has said, you shall not eat it, nor shall you touch it, lest you die." Then the serpent said to the woman. Then the serpent said to the woman, "You will not surely die, for God knows in the day you eat of it, your eyes will be open, and you will be like God, knowing good and evil." So the woman saw that the tree was good for food, that it was pleasant to the eyes, and a tree desirable to make one wise. She took of its fruit and ate. She also gave to her husband with her, and he ate. Then the eyes of both of them were opened, and they knew that they were naked, and they sewed fig leaves together and made themselves coverings. The thing is that Adam failed the Lord because he should have said to the woman, don't eat of that fruit. God has said, don't eat of the fruit, and I command that you don't. But what did Adam do? He listened to the woman. The woman, and you could say, well, okay, the sin hasn't yet touched Adam. Why is he therefore lustful following the woman? Well, first of all, because she was made of the rib of Adam. The woman, the Bible says that God caused Adam to sleep, and he took the rib of Adam and formed a woman. What we need to understand is that what I feel in the faith is that we need to look to Jesus. You know, Jesus being the man of the Son of God, he's the man as well, you know, the man. But what we need to understand is that, you know, all these arguments that the woman is not represented, you know, when we think about, you know, when you think about Genesis 1:27 says, for God created man in his own image, in the image of God he created him, male and female, he created them. When we think about it more carefully, how did Jesus come into the world? He came into the world through the womb of Mary, who was a woman. So that covers the whole spectrum. The problem in this world is sin. The problem in this world is Satan. They're the problems. They're the problems that cause everything that stems from sin. It's everything that it stems from sin, and the worst of it is idolatry. But everything that we see that's evil and wicked in the world comes from the sin and Satan deceiving the world. So when I think of this experience that, you know, someone that says that they're, and I think that we can see where the enemy is working in people. And I feel like the Lord's saying to me, when this woman was asking me about my finances, I felt like the Lord was saying, giving me a bit of a warning, and through some other context that I know, but through prayer, you know, that this is the enemy in this creeping in this situation. Because God's love, agape love, is not of the world. It's the love of God. It's the love of God through Jesus. But the love of God by sending his son Jesus into the world to show us love. That's why God loves us so much, because he sent Jesus into the world. And I know that people are blinded by Satan. They don't understand, because Satan has just gone over time and has deceived so many people in not knowing the truth. And this is why people are not knowing the truth, because they're not reading into God's word and actually seeing the truth of how God sees it. And I've also been made aware of another platform called Facebook, which I think is an alternative to Fakebook, which is Facebook. So in the situation of Christian Connect, I think that there seriously needs to be a vetting of and a screening of people that actually go into this platform to base it on scripture, to weed out those secular characteristics in there, which are, you know, because Jesus said not to lust after money in Matthew 6:24, when he said no man can serve two masters, for either he'll love the one or despise the other, hold the one or hate the other. You can't serve God and mammon. When I was actually talking to this woman, she was saying, well, is it actually mammon to want to invest or buy property or whatever? So the Lord protects, and God protects his children. And I certainly have seen into the face of Satan, and I know, folks, that this you don't want to go there. You don't want to go there. And it's really the face and love of God is far greater, because God does love us. The thing is that we can't fight the devil. But the devil uses people as weapons, because in Hebrews 2, and this is what the scripture says. It says that, and I've read this before, Hebrews 2. It says in Hebrews 2, 8, and set over the works of your hands, you have put all these things under subjection under his feet. For in this he put all the subjection under him. He left nothing that is not put under him. But now we do not see all things put under him, but we see Jesus, who was made a little lower than the angels for the suffering of death, crowned with glory and honor, that he might be the grace of God, might taste death for everyone. So, one of the things that is hoped in this whole ministry that God has placed me in through Christ, Philippians 4:13, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. It's because it's not about me, but to really find, that there are very strong Christian women out there. But there are so many that are secular. There are so many, their hearts are with the world. And I'm sorry, dear, that, when you spoke about money and you're asking me what my interests are in investing and whether there could be a foreseeable future, because I didn't have an interest in chasing money. Well, I'm sorry, but I think, and dare I judge, I think you're the world's in your heart. And I think there are so many Christians that just do not know Christ. And we are in a grave danger here in Australia, because there are so many that even are in the church that are following the world. And Satan is a deceiver, a false angel of light. And I think that when we think about, man and woman in Christ, this is the way I see it, is that, people look at, say, Jesus and say, oh, Jesus is a man. God sent only Jesus into the world, and he was a man. But how did he get into the world? How did he come into the world? Through the womb of Mary. So the woman was involved in the process of bringing Christ into the world, bringing Jesus into the world. So you can't say that women are not represented, because God's love is higher than man and female. God is love in the Trinity. God is all in one, and that's what we forget, and that's what that true love in this world. See, the problem is Satan is working overtime to destroy love and make people into humanoids and make them robotic and destroy them. Playing in sewers or, all those sorts of, or false love, all those things are the work of the enemy. It's not the people that are to blame. It's the fact that that sin has crept into the world by Satan. Satan is the one that we should be avoiding and looking to Christ. But God brought, I believe from my readings, that God brought Satan, evil, into the world because it reinforces our love for God. We would not know perfection if we did not have the ugliness of the enemy, because the more you see the enemy, the more you turn to Christ and the more you love Jesus and think, well, God really loves us. He's the one that really loves us. Satan doesn't give up. There's a fallen angel. He's on the road to destruction. But God loves us. He's the creator. The enemy didn't create us. God created Satan. But God creates everything. He's created everything. But to be able to talk to us in the words of the flesh, he brought Jesus into the world. If you look at the Old Testament, how could people come to God? By the book of Leviticus, there was very, very strict ceremonies to be able, purification, very, very difficult means of coming oneness with God, and that's in the book of Leviticus. If you read about it, the anointing, the Holy of Holies. But by bringing Christ in the world, God is wanting us to come to know him through his Son. And I think it's sad that, that there's a misunderstanding in these dating websites, and I think there should be an overhaul of them. And I think there should be the implementation of scripture and testing of faith to make sure and to ensure that people that are in these platforms are actually genuine and are with the Lord. So as I conclude in this video, I'm going to just have a look through Facebook and see what it's about. And, you know, it's just, I just read this in Acts, for example, in Acts 10, 13 to 15, it says, or 11, it says, and so Acts 10, 12, it says, in it we were all kinds of four-footed animals of the earth, wild beasts, creeping things, and birds of the air. And a voice came to him, "Rise, Peter, kill and eat." But Peter said, "Not so, Lord, for I have never eaten anything common or unclean." And a voice came to him again the second time, "What God has cleansed, you must not call common." This was done three times, and the object was taken up into heaven. Now, while Peter wondered with himself what this vision which he had seen meant, behold, the men who had been sent from Cornelius had made inquiry for Simon's house and stood before the gate. And they called and asked whether Simon, whose surname was Peter, was lodging there. While Peter thought about the vision, the Spirit said to him, "Behold, three men are seeking you. Arise, therefore, go down with them, and doubting nothing, for I have sent them." Then Peter went down to the men who had been sent to him from Cornelius and said, "Yes, I am he who you seek. For what reason have you come?" And they said, "Cornelius, the centurion, a just man, one who fears God and has a good reputation among all nations of the Jews, was divinely instructed by a holy angel to summon you to his house and to hear words from you." Then he invited them in and lodged them. On the next day, Peter went away with them, and some brethren from Joppa accompanied him. And the following day, they entered Caesarea. Now Cornelius was waiting for them and had called together his relatives and close friends. And as Peter was coming in, Cornelius met him and fell down at his feet and worshipped him. But Peter lifted him up, saying, "Stand up, I myself am also a man." So, you know, Peter was saying that he was just like anyone else, but he was with the Lord. And he talked with him. He went in and found many who had come together. And, you know, as we read God's word, God speaks to us. He said to them, "You know how unlawful it is for a Jewish man to keep company with or to go to another nation, but God has shown me that I should not call any man common or unclean." So there's more and more here that goes on about Peter. I may as well read the rest of it. I feel like the Lord's talking. So Acts 10:28 says, "Then he said to them, 'You know how unlawful it is for a Jewish man to keep company with or go to one of another nation, but God has shown me that I should not call any man common or unclean. Therefore I came without objection. As soon as I went, I was sent for. I asked, for what reason have you sent me?'" And, you know, people like ourselves on the spectrum, I think that when we know the Lord, we know the words of Jesus, you know, "Enter by the narrow gate." You know, so many of us, and I'm not saying I am, but so many follow the devil. And, you know, if we follow Christ and we follow the Lord, we really do see the areas of sin. We see the problems of sin, not in ourselves, but in others around us. You can thumbs down this, I don't really care, but it's what the Lord says. So Cornelius said, "4 days ago I was fasting until this hour." And what I mean by that is that I'm with the Lord, so I'm hearing, you know, whatever the public opinion is of this video, and it's not about me, you know, I'm sharing God's word. So Cornelius said, "4 days ago I was fasting until this hour, and at the 9th hour I prayed in my house, and behold, a man stood before me in the bright clothing and said, 'Cornelius, your prayer has been heard, and your alms are remembered in the sight of God. Send therefore to Joppa and call Simon here, whose surname is Peter. He is lodging in the house of Simon, a tanner by the sea. When he comes, he will speak to you. So I sent you immediately, and you have done well to come. Now therefore we are all present before God to hear all things commanded you by God.' Then Peter opened his mouth and said, 'In truth, I perceive that God shows no partiality, but in every nation, whoever fears him and works righteousness is accepted by him. The word which God sent to the children of Israel, preaching peace through Jesus Christ, he is the Lord of all. That word you know, which was proclaimed through all Judea and began from Galilee after the baptism in which John preached. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power, who went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. And we are witnesses of all things which he did, both in the land of the Jews and Jerusalem, whom they killed by hanging on a tree. Him God raised up on the third day and showed him openly, not to all the people, but to witness chosen before by God, even to us who ate, drank with him after he arose from the dead. And he commanded us to preach the people to testify that it is he who ordained by God to judge the living and the dead. To him all the prophets witness through his name. Whoever believes in him will receive remission of sins. While Peter was still speaking these words, the Holy Spirit fell upon all those who heard the word, and those of the circumcision who believed were astonished, as many as came with Peter, because the gift of the Holy Spirit had been poured out on the Gentiles also. For they heard them speak with tongues and magnify God. And Peter answered, "Can anyone forbid water that these should not be baptized who had received the Holy Spirit just as we have?" And he commanded them to be baptized in the name of the Lord. Then they asked him to stay a few days. So just in conclusion, you know, we just hand people over to God. So this lady that dumped me, I just hand her over to God, like anyone else. Hand over to God. So just in a prayer, dear Lord, I just pray to you this evening, this afternoon, ask you to bless this prayer and invite Jesus into this prayer. Lord, I pray so much for your grace, mercy, love, and strength. I pray so much for this fallen and broken world that people will come to know Jesus, your Son, our Lord. And Lord, that people will turn to you. But Lord, we know that we can't defeat the enemy. We know that Jesus has won this battle, and we look to him for strength, Lord. And Lord, I just pray over this lady that she finds the man that she's looking for, obviously a man that has money, because that's what she's wanting. And I pray, Lord, to find true love in you in Christ. I pray to find, for all those that really want to know you, the real means of your love. And Lord, I pray that I don't see autism as seen as a world a label, but Lord, it's really it is a blessing, because we see the world differently and uniquely. And I pray, Lord, that I can continue to work in your strength, in your oneness, and just to Ephesians 2:8-9, for by grace you have been saved through faith, and not of yourselves, it is the gift of God, not of works, lest anyone should boast. I pray, Lord, so much in the wonderful and precious name of Jesus. Amen. Thanks very much for watching. May God bless you.